Welcome to Data Science Methodology 101, From Understanding to Preparation, Data Preparation Case Study. In a sense, data preparation is similar to washing freshly picked vegetables insofar as unwanted elements, such as dirt or imperfections, are removed. So now, let's look at the case study related to applying data preparation concepts. In the case study, an important first step in the data preparation stage was to actually define congestive heart failure. This sounded easy at first, but defining it precisely was not straightforward. First, the set of diagnosis-related group codes needed to be identified, as congestive heart failure implies certain kinds of fluid buildup. We also need to consider that congestive heart failure is only one type of heart failure. Clinical guidance was needed to get the right codes for congestive heart failure. The next step involved defining the readmission criteria for the same condition. The timing of events needed to be evaluated in order to define whether a particular congestive heart failure admission was an initial event, which is called an index admission, or a congestive heart failure-related readmission. Based on clinical expertise, a time period of 30 days was set as the window for readmission relevant for congestive heart failure patients, following the discharge from the initial admission. Next, the records that were in transactional format were aggregated, meaning that the data included multiple records for each patient. Transactional records included professional provider facility claims submitted for physician, laboratory, hospital, and clinical services. Also included were records describing all the diagnoses, procedures, prescriptions, and other information about inpatients and outpatients. A given patient could easily have hundreds or even thousands of these records, depending on their clinical history. Then, all the transactional records were aggregated to the patient level, yielding a single record for each patient as required for the decision tree classification method that would be used for modeling. As part of the aggregation process, many new columns were created representing the information in the transactions. For example, frequency and most recent visits to doctors, clinics and hospitals with diagnoses, procedures, prescriptions, and so forth. Comorbidities with congestive heart failure were also considered, such as diabetes, hypertension, and many other diseases and chronic conditions that could impact the risk of readmission for congestive heart failure. During discussions around data preparation, a literary review on congestive heart failure was also undertaken to see whether any important data elements were overlooked, such as comorbidities that had not yet been accounted for. The literary review involved looping back to the data collection stage to add a few more indicators for conditions and procedures. Aggregating the transactional data at the patient level meant merging it with the other patient data, including their demographic information, such as age, gender, type of insurance, and so forth. The result was the creation of one table containing a single record per patient, with many columns representing the attributes about the patient in his or her clinical history. These columns would be used as variables in the predictive modeling. Here is a list of the variables that were ultimately used in building the model. The dependent variable, or target, was congestive heart failure readmission within 30 days following discharge from a hospitalization for congestive heart failure, with an outcome of either yes or no. The data preparation stage resulted in a cohort of 2,343 patients meeting all of the criteria for the case study. The cohort was then split into training and testing sets for building and validating the model, respectively. This ends the data preparation section of this course, in which we apply the key concepts to the case study. Thanks for watching.